Hi viewer, I welcome you to Elim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Mathematics Form 3, Lesson Number 16. The topic is the trigonometric radius. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. Let us look at our lesson course today. We are going to use mathematical tables to find the trigonometric radius of angles. Also, you use the calculators to find the trigonometric radius. And then we find the radian measure. We start by using the mathematical table. We have an example there. Find the cosine, sine, tangent of the following angles. I have the angle there, which is 307 degrees, 24 minutes. Then the other one, it is 137.8 degrees. Then 230 degrees. Then 329 degrees, 30 minutes. How do I go about this? When you happen to visit the mathematical table, you are going to get that we only get the trigonometric radius of acute angles, those angles that are less than 90 degrees. So what do I do? All those angles that I have, they are more than 90 degrees. What do I do? Take for example, the first one. We take the first one. Before we come to the mathematical table, you can be able to see that is how it is arranged. But in my first case, I have 307 degrees and 24 minutes, which I'm supposed to get the acute angle there. And in my case, how do I get the acute angle? I will take now the next 90 degrees that is next to 307 degrees and 24 minutes, which is supposed to be 360 degrees. So when you subtract, you are going to get an angle there, which is supposed to be 32 degrees and 36 minutes. How do I go about it? I will go to the mathematical table. This one, it is for the cosine. Not cosine, but sine. So when it comes to that 33, I'll go and get where it is, 32 degrees. You can see mine, it is all the way up to 29 degrees. Then it has minutes on the top one, which is going to 60. Then we have the small table. So in my case, I cannot read my value. But in mathematical table, you are going to get, it is there. I'll take, for example, a situation where you have 20 degrees and 24 minutes. How do I go about it? I have the 20 degrees there. I'd go along it. Then I get the 24 minutes on top there. Where they intersect, that is my trigonometry. That is my sine of 20 degrees and 24 minutes. For example, in my case, I can be able to get, it's supposed to be 0.38 3486. That is the way I'm supposed to read it, and that becomes the answer. Let's take another example for the sine. A situation where you have 29 degrees and 54 minutes. How do I get the sine theta? I'll just happen to visit there. Then go to 29 degrees. You can be able to see that is the last one that I have. Then you go to the other side. You are going to get the value, 54 minutes. Where they intersect, it's supposed to be 0.4985. That is the way you are supposed to read the mathematical table. And this one now, it is when now we want to convert them into radians. You can be able to see how we convert them into radians. An example, a trigonometric table of sines and cosines is in degrees and minutes. So we can convert it. From degrees, you can see where the degrees are and where the minutes are. Sine 9 degrees can be read as you could just go where the degrees are, get 9, then the first value, which is supposed to be 0.1564. That is the answer. And then the others, for example, when you want to get the cos of 76 degrees, you just get it, which is 0.2419 from the mathematical table. So that is how you are supposed. For example, you can be able to see on the other column of mine, you have the cos. The other side, that is on my right-hand side. We have 76. You can be able to see 76 where it is. Then you come and get the readings. The first value there, because it is, doesn't have the decimal point, you're going to get it is 0.2419. How do we get in case the angles are greater than 90 degrees? This is already I've discussed about it. Find the acute angle for the angle. Then number two, find the trigonometric ratios from the mathematical table. We have an example. This is the simple trigonometric ratios equation. Solve the equation. Sine x is equal to 0.8071. And in that case, for the angles that are between 0 degrees and 360, how do we get it? Sine given is positive, so it is either in the first quadrant or the second quadrant. And the angles must be less than 180 degrees. Finding the tables of cosine, the acute angle whose sine is 0.8071 is 53.81. So in that case now, you happen to have x is either 53.81 degrees, or when we subtract 53.81 degrees from 180, in that case, you get it is 1.26.19. How do you use the calculator? Just using the calculator, you press the way they are, tan 30 degrees, tan 330, and then the answers are going to be displayed on your calculator. That one, it is very simple. Just press in the calculator the angle. That is the way. You can also get the sine inverse. This is the activity. You are supposed to use the calculator to get that sine 0.9064. You get the sine inverse using the shift. You happen to have that. Another examples of the equation, zero is equal to 0.640 between 0.2 and 360. Then use the calculator to solve. So we have 8 sine theta is equal to 3, and 16 cos theta minus 12 is equal to 0. Then 2 plus 3 tan theta is equal to 0. Radian measure. 1 radian is an angle subtended at the center by an arc in length, radius. It is denoted by radian. Radius is equal to 0. C. You get it by taking 2 pi c is equal to 360. So 1 radian is supposed to be 57.29 in 4 significant figures. You are trying to convert that. Then the assignment for today, find all the values of theta and 360 degrees, satisfying the equation 5 sine theta is equal to negative 4. Using the mathematical tables, write down the tan, sine, cos, log cos of the following angles, 67.342 and 80.123. For more information, visit the KRB 2003 Secondary Book 3. You can get us through the SMSing, YouTube. You can also get us from the Facebook, or you can Twitter us. Thank you. Stay tuned. 2022.